Welcome back again. We are dealing with the scaling up of bioreactors. And in this section, we will be studying about the fundamental requirement, that is, the small and large reactor should be similar. That is, whether it is the laboratory scale or the pilot or the commercial scale, we have to see that the reactors, the geometry of the reactors are similar. Only then, even the biological, physical, and chemical parameters which we spoke and which will be speaking still further will all add up to the upliftment of the scaling up of the bioreactors. There are two types of similarity. One is the geometrical similarity of the reactors and dynamic similarity of flow fields. Now, what do you mean by this geometrical similarity? Means the small and large reactor should have the same shape, and all the linear dimensions of the small reactor should be related to corresponding dimension of the large bioreactor by a constant scale factor. That is, your geometrical similarity means whether it is a large scale reactor or a small scale reactor, geometrically they have to be similar in their shape and also in the linear dimensions. And so let me explain you with a simple example. So suppose, say, this is a fermenter and this is another fermenter, this is large fermenter and this is a small scale fermenter. So what you will be having, we will have an impeller, right? And here also we are having an impeller. Okay, so this is a small scale fermenter. So the height of this I'll mention in small letter and here in capital letter, and the diameter in small letter and here in capital letter, and the dimensions of my impeller in small d and I, here capital D and I. So therefore, the height of my large fermenter and the small fermenter is equal to the diameter of my large fermenter and small fermenter, and it is also equal to the dimension of my impeller, I mean capital D and small di. So this all should be constant. That is, they are equal, they are proportional by a common factor, that is alpha. Okay, that is the meaning. So your height or the diameter or your impeller size all should be in a constant. That is the meaning of geometrically similarity between your large and your small scale reactor. Another is the dynamic similarity, dynamic similarity of flow fields. Now, at a similar location, okay, the fluid particles should experience, okay, your fluid particles should experience same forces, okay, they should experience the same forces which are acting on the fluid particles. So whether it is a large reactor or the small reactor, okay, at a similar location, the fluid particles should experience the same forces which are acting on the fluid particles. They both should be same. Then the dynamic similarity of the two flow fields with geometrically similar boundary is achieved, The flow fields exhibit geometrically similar flow patterns. Okay, so what happens? So here we are talking about the ratio of the flow velocity of the corresponding fluid particles which is there in your reactor, whether it is your large reactor or the large or the small reactor. What is the flow velocity in this? Okay, the flow velocity of the fluids should be same in both the reactor, as well as the forces which are acting also should be same. When your dynamic similarity and your geometrical similarity is achieved, the flow fields exhibit geometrically similar flow patterns. So it will be similar both dynamically and geometrically, whether your reactor is large or whether it is small. So now we have spoken about the scaling up, and we told that we have to still will be speaking about the mass transfer, oxygen transfer, all in detail. But for scaling up, what are the drawbacks in scaling up? We have seen that, but once again we'll look into a clearer picture. In reality, scale up of laboratory and pilot plant data to commercial size industrial bioreactors is very difficult and complicated. This is the first sentences which we started when we spoke about the scaling up of the bioreactors. No actual data or correlation exists for the scale up. Different people use different scale up criteria to design commercial size bioreactor systems. That is, if I am going to choose one type of product to be produced by my industry, I will go according to it. Okay, so I will not be giving out my data to anyone else. And whatever the data is available, I can have it as a blueprint and can modify whatever I want according to it. So no actual data correlation exists for the scale up in that cases. And therefore, different people use different scale up criteria to design the commercial size bioreactor systems. Okay, according to their production, according to their investment, okay, there will be either minor or major changes. Also, in industry, there are a lot of trade secrets on scale up of bioreactors, and very few published results exist in the literature. This is true because this is somewhat related to your intellectual property. It is. And you can go for patent when you get a very good product or a process patent or a product patent, particularly product patent, you can go for it. And that is why usually they don't like, particularly you see that the industries do not publish much because they are concentrating more on the patenting of their product or transfer of technology. So oxygen transfer is much difficult to obtain in large scale fermenter due to the surface to volume ratio. But oxygen transfer is very essential since most of your commercial fermentation are aerobic. If aeration is reduced even for short period of time, the culture may experience partial or complete product yield getting adversely affected. So oxygen transfer becomes an important parameter. The task of the engineer is to carefully handle the industrial process, and one should have a full knowledge or familiarity with gas transfer, fluid dynamics, mixing, thermodynamics, the kinetics, or totally in one word, all what is required in a chemical engineering technology. The availability of microbial strains required for large-scale production is very often hindered. If the strain, it works sometimes well in the laboratory scale and does not work well in the production fermenter. This is where the biotechnologists can come for the rescue. They can modify or manipulate the strains so that at genetic level we can modify and can produce a better strain. At last, the entire team of whoever are involved in the scaling up of commercialization of the product, they need to spend the time and effort with your team to brainstorm all conceivable risk, and for each risk rate, the probability of occurrence and severity, if it does occur, and prepare a detailed risk mitigation plan. So it is not a one-man player. The entire team should be involved, okay? And they should see that what are the risk factors which are present, and what is causing this risk factor, and what is the probability of that again occurrence of this risk, what can be the severity of this risk if it occurs. You should prepare a detailed list of this risk, and you should plan how you can mitigate the risk or avoid the risk in future. So by this we can see to that we can get a better product, better commercialization. At the same time, whoever has invested their monetary get a better benefit out of it. So it is just not looking only into the part of the money or the product. Both has to be balanced. So this we can conclude our class on the scaling up of the bioreactors, and we can take up the next class, a new chapter. Thank you.